This is property number 5 for Sarah Larbi.
Hi guys, how are you?
We've done a few BRRRRs and this one we really did well on. We actually bought it sight unseen. I don't have time to go back and forth and back and forth for a property or two to maybe see if I like it or not. When we bought the property, we actually ended up buying it within 4 hours, sight unseen.
Was this asking?
Asking was 130 in the 4 offers in total.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So we just went, no conditions, and we went with this price. So profit of $93,000.
That's amazing, especially just like thinking about doing this in under a year. Here we are today, guys, in Brantford, Ontario with Sarah Larbi.
Hi.
And we're going to be talking about how she's BRRRRing here and crushing it. Great deals, great cash flow, great video. We are here today in Brantford and we're checking out BRRRR property. This is property number 5 for Sarah Larbi.
Hi guys, how are you?
And so it looks beautiful inside. We already took a quick peek, but Sarah's going to give us a tour right now. So let's jump into it.
All right, let's do it.
So walk us through this, Sarah.
Yeah, absolutely.
You're telling me it's kind of an interesting story behind how you bought the property.
Yeah, so this essentially was one of our probably more successful BRRRs that we've done. We've done a few BRRRs, and this one we really did well on. We actually bought it sight unseen. We had worked with the realtor for a while, so we had built a good team already, and we knew the area and the market really well. And so within 4 hours of it hitting, we ended up buying it, and this was $151,000. It was super dated. I'll walk you guys through that, and we'll put some before pictures as well. And, you know, put about $30,000 of reno work to make it look like this. So if you can imagine, like, this was actually completely closed in. There was like a tiny little doorway here, and there was this shag carpeting. If you can imagine purple, this like person that lived here before loved purple. So the bathtub was purple, the wallpaper everywhere was purple, there was a bunch of wall paneling. So we started renovating. Actually, we found this awesome floor underneath. Don't you love it when you're renovating and you don't have to worry about the flooring because all of a sudden you've got this awesome hardwood underneath. So that saved us some good coin there. This property, essentially, it was listed as a 2-bedroom, but I'll show you guys that there is actually technically a third bedroom in the back as well. So it was these 2 bedrooms, there was a little tiny doorway, and then the kitchen. The kitchen was actually quite something because the stove wasn't even in the actual kitchen. So we didn't do too much in this room, like, other than put...
You bought this house cash without ever seeing it.
That's right. This is not the first and last either.
So you're not playing around, obviously. So one of the first questions my audience is going to have is, how do you do it? Like, how do you get comfortable offering cash on a property that you've never seen before?
Yeah, so because we knew the market really, really well, like, I know the area in Brantford that I like, I know the streets, I know what rents I'm going to get, I know what, like, prices of the houses are going to be average, I know what a deal is, because that's the point of not going and buying a house in St. Catharines and then a house in Peterborough and then a house in Brantford, because at some point you're just not going to know what the deals actually, where they are.
Yeah.
And so because we were just specifically, when I say we, mean my spouse, he's not into real estate as much, but he enjoys it now.
Yeah.
After some time. But it was just working with a realtor that is also an investor, and, you know, your whole team, whether it's your mortgage broker, your tax accountant, ideally they're also investors themselves and they work with investors, and so they went to check it out for us because they're local. And that's another big thing is, mm-hmm, ideally your realtors are local. Like, I have a realtor for my cottage area in Kawartha's that I'm looking for something else, and she found us that cottage, and I wouldn't use that same person for anything else other than what they're specializing in. Just like in Brantford, I want somebody that's local. They might get pocket listings as well, but they can also go and view the properties on our behalf. I don't have time to go back and forth and back and forth for a property or two to maybe see if I like it or not. It's good enough, you know, they know what we like. I don't mind a little bit of you know, sweat equity. I'm not the one doing it, of course, but you know, it's, you got to just take action on things and you got to move quickly, because in this time now there's just so many investors and there's so many multiple offers. I mean, this was even a multiple offer listing and we had to remove conditions. It was actually an estate sale, and so when you have estate sales, the less conditions you have, the better.
Yeah.
Right, so that they can make the decision and then it's all done. And and just like working with a good team of people, so make sure that they're local, make sure that they are investors themselves, that they specialize working with investors, and it makes your life so much easier. easier.
Fantastic tips.
Sarah, everyone on my YouTube channel loves diving into the numbers, so we really appreciate you laying it out for us. So walk us through, what are we looking at here?
Yeah, absolutely. So when we bought the property, we actually ended up buying it within 4 hours, sight unseen. I don't recommend that everybody does that just because it's a little bit risky. But because we had worked with our realtor already for our first four, this was number five, we were able to trust him and he knew what we wanted and just went through it for us. And then we just put in an offer like within 4 hours. So we got it at this price, which is incredible. And so we bought it for $151,000.
So was this asking?
Asking was 130 in the four offers in total.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So we just went no conditions and we went with this price, but they probably could have got a lot more for it. But regardless, you know what, we ended up trying to test just the rents, looking, you know, how it looked before, very old and run down, but just very old fashioned,
dated
and all that stuff. So we ended up actually renting it to somebody that didn't want to remove any of the wall paneling, like the shag carpeting and all the purple. And so that was $1,300. And so we were actually pretty good.
Yeah.
We were pretty happy. Like, it's not the 1%, but it's close to 1% for Canada.
And they're paying utilities too here.
Absolutely. It's plus utilities, single family properties. All the utilities are paid by the tenants. So then they ended up breaking up and then so they moved out. And we said, okay, well, this is a good chance to BRRRR it, because that's what we wanted to do originally. And so we ended up renovating it, took about 2.5 months, and we spent about $30,000 in total. That included the kitchen, that included some of the flooring that you saw, not the nice wood that we found, but the rest of the flooring. That included, actually, the roof was recently redone.
Oh, really? That's included?
That's included. Great. Yeah, the roof, I think, cost us, it was under $3,000. It was like maybe $2,500, give or take. But, you know, labor was included in that. So everything, all in all, 2.5 months later, we ended up getting an appraisal coming back at $275,000.
That's amazing.
It is pretty cool. Like, you don't always get, I mean, I look at it and I'm like, this is a home run.
Yes.
But you don't always get that. And, you know, sometimes you're going to take all your money out. Sometimes you're not going to. But in this case, we ended up doing it and we got all our money out and then some. Total profit, you know, with the new rent. So what we ended up doing is once we got the appraisal done, we ended up renting it for the new rent, which is $1,545, which cash flow is about $250 a month.
Mm-hmm.
Still good cash flow,
yeah.
Even after the higher refinanced amount. And this was actually a cash out refinance. So sometimes we refinance as a home equity line of credit, but in this case, because the rent was still covering and giving us enough cash flow, we just actually pulled out the entire amount that we ended up getting. So the profits in the whole entire deal within a matter, I would say, between the time that we bought it, the time that the original tenants moved out, and the time that it took for renovations, I would say it's about 9 months later.
Yeah.
You know, the 6 months time that they were living in there plus 2.5 months.
Mm-hmm.
So profit of $93,000, surplus cash was about $38,000.
Yeah, that's amazing, especially just like thinking about doing this in under a year.
Yeah. I mean, you know, at the end of the day, this is why we're in the real estate game. You know, it's fun. There's pros and cons, but you know, this kind of stuff is how you create that freedom for yourself, and you don't work 40 hours for 40 years and retire when you're 65, you know? So that's, to us, this makes more sense.
Love it.
So we didn't do too much in this room, like, other than put the lighting and the little finishing touches. We put a lot into the kitchen. It wasn't actually that much money. It was about $8,000 to do the kitchen, including the appliances that we usually end up finding good deals on Kijiji. So people wanting to replace their appliances, these are perfectly fine. They were super cheap in comparison. So our kitchen was probably the biggest change, just because it was not even functioning before. There's this wall here of empty space and just a bunch of old cupboards. Like, if you can imagine your grandma's house 50 years ago, that's what it looked like. So we modernized it a little bit, added some lighting, got the stainless steel appliances in the countertops. And you know, it's like kitchens and bathrooms and flooring. Those are the things that I like the most in terms of doing upgrades to property. I don't like doing windows. I don't like doing foundation. I like doing something where I can bring up the value with as little amount of permits as possible that I need to pull, and just like a lot of the cosmetic stuff that is often what brings up the value. So that's what we did. And then this room over here, so this was the rest of the kitchen. So there's this wall here, and then the stove used to be here. And then there was this empty space here. The laundry, like actually we put in that wall so that we can separate it a little bit. Now they've got the dining space. And then this was a nice surprise over here.
Correct me if I'm wrong, Sarah, but you don't live here in Brantford, right?
No, there's not enough Starbuckses here. No, I'm just kidding.
I believe her on that.
Yeah, there's three now, but yes.
So why Brantford?
Well, originally we didn't even have a plan. It was because my boyfriend's sister needed a place to live.
Okay.
And so the first house that we bought was actually for her, and it was based on an area that she wanted for her daughter's school. But afterwards I really started doing research and realized that this area here is, in my opinion, is still undervalued. There's lots of things that are going well for Brantford. It was actually number one actually last year in best places to invest, Money Sense magazine.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah. But you know, like there's lots of things I like about it. I mean, Laurier, the campus is growing. I mean, they're going from 4,000 or 5,000 students to, you know, they're adding 5,000 or 6,000 more in the next few years. There's obviously more transportation improvements between here and Hamilton. But most importantly, the numbers made sense. And that, you know, I look at cash flow first. I don't need the 1% rule that they say in the US, but you know, the cash flow plus the mortgage pay down plus a little bit of appreciation, to me, I'm happy. But this is one of the things when people ask me what happens if the market tanks. I mean, I don't care. My rents aren't going down. I mean, this area has such a low vacancy. Mm-hmm. Southern Ontario, as yeah. you know, just the vacancy rate, like we have a housing shortage problem. So if the properties all of a sudden go down 20%, I'm still cash flowing. I'm still renting out my properties and making money at the end of every single month after I pay expenses, capital expenditure, taxes, and you know, mortgage, insurance, all of that good stuff, and I'm still making money. And if I was to invest where I live, which is in Oakville, I mean, I'd be paying somebody to live and rent there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, great point. And it's something that lots of beginner or novice investors overlook. You know, if we're investing for cash flow, even a small correction in the real estate pricing market isn't going to impact the day-to-day operations of our business.
No, and I will say, I'd be happy because I'm looking, and it might be easier to buy stuff under value, right? And you just, that's what happens when you are an investor. You just make sure that you've got cash for all of the eventualities. And if mm-hmm. that does happen, well, I mean, I'm going to be buying. I'm sure you might be buying too.
if it cash flows, that's what matters to me.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, the biggest thing I think that people don't factor in is mortgage pay down,
mm-hmm.
right? That is like 5 to 6% on your money. Or if you BRRRR, I mean, that's infinity percent because you could potentially pull out most of it, if not all of it. And at some point, you're reusing the bank's money and it doesn't become your own anymore. So we originally saved for the first one and a half, and then we realized that you can actually refinance. We didn't even know what that concept was before.
Yeah.
But that mortgage pay down piece is huge because that plus appreciation over time, it'll even allow you to do it, even if you don't BRRRR, which mm-hmm. is pretty cool. And that's how you scale.
Yeah, I love it, and I love BRRRing.
BRRRing is awesome. We've got the dining space, and then this was a nice surprise over here, which is an actual bedroom, which was not on the listing, so we just literally added the closet. And it is the master bedroom now, and they've got a nice little sunroom to the back. So it had some nice surprises for sure. And we found some great tenants as well. So this place originally when we bought it, this was in 2015, just the end of 2015. And you know, once in a while, like just to test out the market, I like to figure out if I can rent it as is. And believe it or not, somebody loved purple, the wall paneling and everything else, and just wanted to move in right away. And so we originally just had bought it for $151,000, planned to renovate, but they didn't want any renovations. They wanted to move in pretty much right away. So we originally had it rented for $1,300. And so after the renovations, because they ended up breaking up, so they moved out, after the renovations, the current rent is $1,545 at this point in time. But the really cool thing is that we were able to get all of our money out, our down payment money and our renovation costs as well. Because we bought this property so quickly and at such a great deal, and we were able to do the right renovations to really bring up the price. And that's how we did well with this one. I mean, you're not going to have a home run with every single BRRRR that you do, but you know, this one we did pretty well with.
Sarah has built up a massive portfolio here in Brantford, all while working a full-time job.
That's it, full-time.
How'd you do it?
Well, I have a really awesome team in place. I mean, ultimately, you can still self-manage if you're very, very diligent with who you're putting into your units as much as possible. Of course, you can't pick every single person, but if you build a good team, so like I would say, you know, you definitely want a handyman, you want a plumber, you want an HVAC person, an electrician, and when stuff happens, because things happen,
Yeah. They
do, trust me, they do. It's a simple text or call to whoever it is, and they go, and then they just email me the invoice, and because I trust them and I've been, you know, building that team over time, sometimes, you know, you find somebody and they work a little bit and then they don't work a little bit and you got to fire them. But, you know, over time you're going to be all set if you do it right and you just have some key members of your team. And if you're just brand new and you're just getting started, because your realtor is an investor, they probably have their team and you can start building that way.
True.
So that's what we did when we bought the cottage in Peterborough. So we didn't really have a team yet and we just started using the realtor's team and then we just upgrade if anyone needs upgrading over time.
I love it. Systems and delegation, that's the key.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that I was able to provide some insights and help you in your journey to BRRRing and real estate investing. If you wanted to get in touch, feel free to reach out to me. You can email me, which is sarah@sarahlarbi.com. You can follow me on Instagram, Investor Sarah Larbi, or go to my website and check out some of the different courses. There's also a free checklist as well for how to screen tenants and also how to find a great property and a great market. So you can go to sarahlarbi.com for that.
I mean, this feels a lot better than a day job, right?
It does. Work hard, play hard.